All right, guys, here we go. Next game, Silver 2. Ultimate team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game. Andrew Luck, the Brown Marshall, I'm guessing. Game as well. Let's get the party started. All right, here we go.
They met here on the opening Thursday of 2015, and they're at it again here. The Steelers and Pats are underway.
Oh, Doug Baldwin, Alshon Jeffrey.
The first carry now for Adrian Peterson.
And Adrian Peterson.
Play there, second down. And a couple of big boys up front defensively, and in that 4-3, those D tackles so vital.
Extremely vital. I love how you describe that, because if they control things up front, often it's over the guard. Sometimes they slide and make it over the center. It's really hard to get a play started then, because a lot of teams want to start inside out running the football.
Yes! Picked off, baby! Nice! Rob Ninkovic. Yeah! Awesome start, baby.
Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Here's Matt Forte with his first carry. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there.
Nice.
He gets it complete to Anquan Boldin. It's a pickup of 16 there that'll lead to a new set of downs. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back complete.
Looking for Oh, my God. Are you serious? Really? He got that? Come on.
These guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
Wow,
that's... Break the tie. The defense had other plans.
Darn it.
Field goal range. But boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
Here's Luck now on second down.
Come on, drop it. He dropped it. Yes.
Complete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Throwing on third down. Luck. Jeffrey with a catch left side. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
Come on. Oh, my God. Are you serious? Man.
Taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great.
And this is what here? Incomplete.
Nah.
Looked like it was intercepted.
God dang it.
He apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds. On second and 10, Luck.
Nice.
Here's incomplete. They were trying to go to Marshall that time, and it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
A weird type of play.
Extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Here's Luck. Baldwin with it over the middle. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. Throwing is Luck.
Nice!
And it's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Sanders.
There we go. Deion Sanders picks it off on me. I'll pick it off back.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious.
Nice. There we go.
We'll see. Good run. Attack him here. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Second down, Rivers.
God dang it.
Is incomplete. That one intended for Anquan Boldin. And it's third and short.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face, because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner. And usually he's able to use his body and catch the football. But a really nice
play. Got it.
Able to knock it away.
It's a gain of three, and it gets him the first.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
On first and 10, Rivers. Another reception made over the middle. This is Golden. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through.
What the heck was that?
Because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
What?
Hard count might have got him. This might be a first down.
Oh, okay. Nice. Better options than that. Crap.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out.
Oh, my God.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 12.
There is no doubt that Geno Atkins is really strong and stout at the point of attack, but I love his suddenness and the ability to make plays, to be in one spot, and then he's gone and into the offensive backfield. He's a heck of a player.
And there, a big TFL tackle for loss.
Hard to believe that his father, Gene Atkins, was an NFL defensive back and bred this big defensive tackle.
I didn't know.
And the first play will be a field goal try. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside.
He dropped it. Nice.
They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's gonna hurt. 3rd and 5, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Luck now to throw. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. Luck. He completes it to Bryant. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. It'll be a pickup of 12 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Luck on first down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And taking it.
Dang it. Going with these little binky passes here.
13 yards there on the pickup. And it's good enough for a Pittsburgh first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Oh, man.
Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let him get away, but it does get away and it's second down. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Back to the air. Luck on second down.
Oh!
Almost had it. The big
God dang it, man.
Nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete. Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10. Throwing on third down. Luck.
Yeah, baby. Deion Sanders. Oh. Well, that sucks.
The Patriots offense now. They work their way back onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game.
Try to get down the field this time.
And so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. They stay on the ground. Forte again. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43. Deion Sanders, the one to bring him down. Offense coming up, needing 2 yards on third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along.
Boom. Yes.
You control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed.
If I get
the
defense
first.
At one, nope.
Now a second down throw for Rivers. Quick slant.
Nice.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. The four-time Pro Bowler Herman Moore, his first grab of the game.
Led the league in receptions twice. And just think about, he was...
Oh, I could have got a good gain out of that. Darn it.
Circle him, find a way to stop it, and rarely did teams get that done.
Here we go with second and 7.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean, size, the hands, speed. I mean, can flat out run.
Nice.
Package together. You light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw
it. Boom.
Touchdown.
Yay.
Patriots. Jordan Reed from 4 yards out. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
The big fellow was the recipient there.
Nicely done.
It seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to worry about most in the passing game.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy?
Oh, yeah.
His hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Second and 10, Luck again. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
Yeah, gotcha.
Down he goes. Luck is sacked. K'Wan Short. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. They're going to go for it here on fourth. Luck in the offense is going to stay out there. They're going to go. It's Luck. He's got time. Trying to lay one up deep.
Boom!
Be knocked away and incomplete.
All right.
Amazing move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. A first down throw here for Rivers. And that is caught.
Boom!
He'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Herman Moore from 17 yards out, and the Patriots add six to their lead. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Drop.
Free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
On second and 10, Luck.
Sacked.
To escape and he goes down.
Wow.
In there to get him for a loss of five. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
He's
going to
go for a big, and got his man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire half
working
with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
All right.
Again they run, again it's Forte.
Nice.
Down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. They come out here in the eye. On first down, this is Forte.
Oh, and darn it. Wow. Are you freaking kidding me, Matt Forte?
And he takes it back.
A
fumble recovery for a Steelers score. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. You know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? this definitely qualifies.
And they decide fairly early here they need the ball back, so here's an onside kick. And this is secured by the Patriots. I know they're down, but starting the third quarter there with the onside kick, what'd you think?
Well, I think that they're looking at it as we may not have as many possessions in this game as we want. There may be that sense and that feel that they've got to go ahead and make something happen. Steal possession, try and steal some points, and get themselves right back in a position to try and win the game.
It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make it second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Rivers now on second down. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback.
Nice.
And still try and cover downfield.
7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. So another catch for Herman Moore, and back in his day, he was a volume receiver. He still is, I guess.
Yeah, no doubt about it. What do you have, over 100 catches three different times in the league? That's pretty impressive.
Still holds the franchise mark with 123 catches way back in 95. Again, it's Rivers.
Boom. All right.
Mike Evans, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And partner, they found a game.
He quit. Man. Oh, well. Yeah. All right.